Welcome to PyMOL 101 with Molecular Memory. I'm KP, and in this lesson, we'll learn about selection using the protein carbonic anhydrase. Carbon dioxide is a waste product produced by our cells. Only a small percentage of this gas dissolves directly in blood plasma. Some is carried by hemoglobin, but about 70% of it is reacted by carbonic anhydrase and carried to the lungs as water-soluble bicarbonate ions. In the lungs, carbonic anhydrase reverses the reaction, remaking carbon dioxide, which we breathe out. In Lesson 1, we learn to load the biological unit of macromolecules. File, get PDB, type 3UYN, set the assembly to 1, and click Download. Here's carbonic anhydrase. Display the sequence and we're ready to model. From the RCSB page, we can access the manuscript describing this structure. Some manuscripts are behind a paywall, but this is where I found one that gave numbers for the important amino acids in this lesson's structure. Real quick, some terminology. An enzyme is a protein that performs a chemical reaction, making or breaking covalent bonds. The active site is the part of an enzyme where a chemical reaction takes place, and it is made up of amino acids. When we refer to amino acids in a protein, we often call them residues. Back to business. We're going to create and save separate selections for zinc, the active site residues, and the water molecules that interact with the active site. Scrolling through our sequence, we have the amino acid one-letter codes, a zinc ion, and waters. Click on zinc, either in the sequence or by clicking on the gray sphere on the structure in the structure viewer window. The letters SELE come up in the names panel. Click A next to them and choose rename selection. Now in the upper left-hand side of the structure viewer window, a prompt comes up. Delete the letters SELE and type a new name. I'll call this zinc. Now, very important, click somewhere in the blank space in the structure viewer window to clear the selection. Otherwise, the next object you click on will be added to the zinc selection. Now, let's select the amino acid residues that make up carbonic anhydrase's active site. Using the sequence display, scroll back to the amino acids. I'll put the list of amino acids we need on screen. First, we're looking for residue 5. Notice that residue 6 is labeled, so residue 5 is this tryptophan just to the left of it. Click on it to select. Next, we need residue 7. Then N62. Be careful, there's another N, asparagine, right next to it, so be sure you select the correct one. K64 next, then H67. Now H94, 91, 2, 3, 4. Next up is H96, and let's stop here at histidine 119. If it makes it easier for you, you can use the display drop-down menu to change the sequence mode to show three-letter codes. Now, I don't, because I like the way I can see breaks in the sequence with the one-letter codes to easily identify different protein chains and ligands. Notice in the object panel, the letters SELE have popped up again. Rename this to active. A button, rename. Delete SELE, and type active. Click in the blank space of the structure viewer window to clear the selection. But oh no, we forgot two residues. No problem. Just click on active again in the names panel to select it. With this selected, we can add the missing residues. Find threonine 199 and 200 in the sequence and click on them. Added. Click in the blank space. Active site selection complete. Selecting active site residues with the command line is way faster. Here's the command on screen. You can pause if you're interested. The different ways we represent structures are called renderings. In PyMOL, the protein is shown as a cartoon rendering by default. It makes sense to show our active site residues in a way that lets us see the atoms, though, since they'll interact with the reactants as the chemical reaction takes place. Add stick rendering to show the active site residues. Next to active in the names panel, click S for show and select sticks. What PyMOL is doing is layering representations on top of each other. Now let's see what show as does. Active, S, show as sticks. Whoa, parts of the protein cartoon get chopped out. Let's not do that. Click S next to active and add the cartoon back in. Let's zoom in on the active site. Names panel active A, zoom. Notice how parts of the structure fade. Some clipping has been applied. Check out video 1 for a description of clipping and how to adjust it. PyMOL can automatically find the interactions that polar atoms make. Find active in the names panel. Click A, find polar contacts to any atoms. Notice yellow dotted lines show the interactions. Let's do the same for zinc. A, find polar contacts to any atoms. Now we have two different sets of contacts in the names panel. Notice some water molecules have interactions with the active site amino acid residues and zinc. Let's select them by clicking on them in the structure. Rotate and zoom as needed to find them all. Now save this selection. A, rename, delete SELE, and let's call this active water. Now we'll hide the rest of the water in the structure. Next to 3UYN, click the hide button, H, waters. But we do want to show waters in the active site. Next to active water, S, spheres. This applies a rendering called space fill, but the waters look huge and might obstruct parts of the active site. Let's resize them using a preset PyMOL has built in. Next to active water, A, preset, ball and stick. Ah, that's much better. The interactions look bad because some of them look like they're going to nowhere. They're actually contacting residues or waters we haven't shown. I'll show you how to fix that in an episode on measurement, but for now, let's just turn them off by deselecting them in the names panel. When we display amino acids as sticks, PyMOL shows the atoms that make up both the backbone and side chain. The backbone atoms connect the groups that form new covalent bonds when the protein is made, and the side chain is the variable group, the R group on that specific amino acid. We can show or hide each of these separately. So next to active, select H, main chain. That hides the backbone. To add it back in, show, main chain, sticks. We've done a ton of work. Control S to save this PyMOL session somewhere on your computer. We'll use it in lesson 3. Hope to see you next time.